I kept thinking, there's got to be something that you want me to do. So what? Tell me, help me, show me.
Sometimes I look at him and I still can't believe I have a son.
When you look at the Bible, miracles are God's way of increasing our faith. I think God wanted to increase my faith that he's still willing to do great things. But at that point, I had such a hard time believing what I was seeing that it was stressful to me.
I was eating one night after work and I felt something in my throat, and the next thing I knew there was just blood everywhere. I couldn't stop the bleeding. It was a good hour. So I drove myself to the emergency room. They decided they were going to do an MRI, which I didn't understand because I just thought, you know, I cut something, can't you sew it up? Within 40 minutes, they came back and said, you have stage 4 kidney cancer. Had I not had that happen, I never knew I had cancer. I had no symptoms. They said the tumor on my kidney was as big as the kidney. It was completely grown around it. I had no symptoms. They took the kidney out. I started, I got a kidney cancer specialist. She told me there was no hope. I would die within 5 years. There is no cure for kidney cancer at my advanced stage. During this time, I had over 1,000 different people and prayer groups praying for me. I started praying a different way. Instead of just praying the prayers in a hymnal, I really started just talking to God. And I do believe that he did want a deeper relationship with me. I was going through the motions before. But I kept having, you know, these dark thoughts, you know, you're gonna die, this is gonna kill you. And I was fighting it every day. I went for my next MRI, and as I'm laying on the table, but in my mind, the Holy Spirit and the devil were fighting. And so I just kept saying, go away, Holy Spirit, take care of this, go away. And all of a sudden I just got like a complete heat that went all through my body, and then a chill, and it was gone. And the girl over the speaker says, that was the weirdest thing ever. And the MRI came back, no cancer, no nothing.
I got married at 41 years old, and we decided that we wanted to try to have a child. The doctor said I had a 10% chance of getting pregnant on my own. I did take some hormonal things and nothing worked. It was very frustrating. It was a very hard time to go through because there was nothing wrong with me. It just wasn't happening. And after that, I kind of gave up because I was an emotional wreck with it. And I told the doctor, I'm sorry, but I'm just not going to be able to do this. This is just too much for me. If God wants me to have a child, I'm going to have a child. I mean, I didn't pray for it, but my mother, she prayed so hard during that time.
My name is Inam Dabish. I am her mother. Well, I have a lot of devotion to St. Anne. When I pray from St. Anne, she answered me. And I asked St. Anne, I say, I want to be grandma like you.
My mother ended up going to the St. Anne feast, and she met a lady. And this lady told her, you know, I'm going to pray for your daughter. Don't worry.
And she come to me, you know, what's your daughter's name? I say, it's Lena. She lift her hand to the statue. She tell her, St. Anne, open her wound, how your wound was open. And she told me, next month, your daughter should be pregnant. When I come home, I tell her, you know, she laughed at me, you know.
Yeah, I just looked at her like, okay, mom, okay, okay. Well, the following month, I wasn't feeling very well. And my husband's like, take a fertility test. I said, no, I'm not. I'm not going to take it. I don't want to go back into that. So I went to the bathroom and I ended up looking at the test. And I said, you know what, let me just take the test. And it turned positive, and I just started screaming at the top of my lungs. We have a beautiful boy. He was born March 30th of 2019.
we thank the Lord, you know, for the miracle for my baby.
So this COVID epidemic came upon us and things were getting really bad and we saw people were afraid, and a group of us, we have a men's group, and we wanted to do something. So a friend of mine named Richard Hess asked me if I would like to meet in front of St. John Hospital, which is our local hospital, and pray. And I said, yeah, I'd love to do that. And St. John Hospital happens to be where Solanus Casey had died in 1957. So we would carry the icons of Solanus Casey, and then we knelt in front of the hospital. At the top of St. John Hospital, there's a crucifix, and we knelt and faced the crucifix and just gave our prayers. As we started praying, the cases peaked, and a few weeks into praying, the cases were almost zero. So we had some incidences of people that we prayed for that we believe are miracles. And one was, we have a young woman who works for a group that I'm involved with. And I sent her a text and said, hey, why don't you come pray with us? And she came to pray and she said, 5 minutes before I received your text, I received a text from my mother saying that my sister, Autumn, is being admitted to St. John Hospital. She had been tested with COVID and was short of breath, couldn't breathe, had a high fever, was feeling dizzy, weak. So she came to pray with us, and we called out. We called for the intercession of Blessed Solanus Casey, and we had confidence in our prayer, like Jesus said. And we found out that she got to the hospital to be admitted, and immediately her fever broke. She had no more shortness of breath and felt great, and they let her go an hour later. So we could call that a coincidence, but as a medical doctor and seeing many patients with COVID, once you start that downward slope, it's almost inconceivable that you would have an immediate, within an hour, break of your fever, break of all your symptoms, especially as you're being admitted to the hospital.
I want to return this great gift that's been given to me. I have my life back. I'm going to have a future with my grandkids. You know, it's just phenomenal.
After Xander was born, my faith just couldn't believe that, like, I had a miracle. Like, sometimes I look at him and I still can't believe I have a son.
I think in dark times that God is more willing to act. And, you know, we're in dark times right now. People have walked away from God. And I know as a doctor, the numbers of patients asking for Xanax and anxiety medicine and depression medicine, it's just huge. People are frightened. And I believe that God is reaching down and allowing more miracles of all sorts to help us. And we just have to be able to work with him.